Yeah, that's right, we are back. Today I'm pretty excited because I've taken a trip out to Playing Place Skatepark. Now this is one of the oldest bowls in the country. It dates from the 1970s and it caught my eye because I reckon it would be a prime place for a little bit of surf skate action. Let's take a look around. So here we are, and oh my goodness, looking pretty 70s. As with a lot of 70s skate parks, there is no coping. You can just roll over the edge. There looks to be a few modern features added. A little bit of a curb there. There's also quite an exciting looking parking curb style section there. The concrete is looking pretty vintage. It's been nicely kept up and repaired though. There are a few gaping holes, but I think my surf skate wheels will be able to cope with this. And there's another more modern looking feature, a bit of a tombstone style affair. Now my initial concern is all of these transitions are really mellow, so it's going to be quite hard to generate speed and maintain speed. But it looks pretty cruisy, rolling in, rolling over the top and back in. Just behind the skate park is a full children's playground and a rather fun looking basketball court, which of course can double up as a place to try your flatland and freestyle tricks. Now I made a bit of a meal of getting here. If you put the postcode for the skate park in the Google Maps, it takes you somewhere else. So probably best put Playing Place Village Hall in the Google Maps and you can't miss it. I can't wait to give it a go. I'm mildly terrified by how rough this concrete is, a bit like sandpaper, so probably don't want to come off. And yesterday I had my biggest slam of the year so far, knocked the old head. So I'm going to pop my helmet on, not going to take any chances. Crikey, that is more exciting than it looks. Probably looks pretty mellow in the video, but the big concern is coming a cropper, skinning the knees on this sandpaper concrete. It's also pretty rough, and there is a danger of going down a pothole and whoo, coming off, so that's always in the back of the mind. It really takes a lot of effort to pump those transitions, and the amount of effort required is probably more like surfing than skating, so the old thighs are burning. After a bit of practice, I managed to find a few lines where I could keep my speed, and I found it good practice to try and pump up back on the top of the transition and then ride along the top and then drop back in. Also, when I was doing my turns, I was trying to remember to swish my legs around, look with my body, and also use my arms, try and generate as much speed as possible, and also try and pump up the transitions as well as back down them. That deep end section is looking prime for a bird slide, so I'm going to see if I can get enough speed to get a bit of a bird slide. Crikey, that concrete is pretty rough and I was starting to wear some holes in my hands, so I had to put my gloves on. It's also quite tricky to break the wheels out, and my enemy was a lack of speed. Really tricky to get enough speed into that deep end to execute a bit of a bird slide, but after a few attempts managed to get a couple to come back in. Well, that's it for my visit to Playing Place Skatepark. I found it a lot of fun. I'd recommend packing some soft wheels. If you've got a surf skate, pop that in the boot as well. Also a set of gloves if you're going to do anything involving touching that concrete. It is like sandpaper. And it's also worth loading in those carbohydrates and coming with a fresh set of legs. If you're new to the channel, feel free to hit subscribe. I make new videos every week. You can also follow me on Instagram at John Bishop Skate. As ever, my name's been John Bishop and I'm a middle-aged guy learning how to skate.